eternity.
And this is my song from 96.3 FM WMBN.
Come so fashion.
You can stay warm as toast this winter and still save money with McGough's great savings on a great selection of in-stock wood stoves, including the famous Peacock wood stoves with the optional blower system that can heat your entire house. Save up to $200 on your new wood stove at McGough's, 501 Lake Avenue, Traverse City.
What a hill.
Yeah, it's some hill.
And what goes up must come down.
Yep, it will go down.
Did you miticize the brakes?
Oh, I took care of the brakes, yeah.
That's good, because what goes up must come down.
Nah, we're just about all the way up.
You did say you miticized the brakes.
No, I didn't.
What? You didn't miticize the brakes?
No.
You walked this hill knowing what goes up must come down, and you didn't miticize the brakes?
Well, I didn't think it mattered. I took it someplace else.
Didn't matter someplace else? Did they guarantee your brake shoes and pads for as long as you own your vehicle?
Oh, no guarantee.
Midas guarantees?
Well, yeah,
Midas guarantees your brake shoes and pads for as long as you own your vehicle.
Yes, but
Midasize your brakes, and then you're backed by the dependable, unbeatable Midas guarantee.
Yeah, but
at Midas, they do it right the first time.
Too late now. What goes up?
Why didn't you Midasize the brakes?
For expert service, see your Petoskey Midas dealer at 1061 U.S. Route 31 North, across from Bayview Golf Course. Midasize. Get it right the first time.
It's 1 minute before 7 o'clock, and you're listening to WMBN-FM 96.3, Petoskey Traverse City. The news this hour being brought to you by Centennial Insurance in Petoskey, an independent agent who works with you and for you on all your insurance needs.
Another incident in the Persian Gulf tanker war. It happened early this morning in the southern part of the Gulf. An Iranian gunboat fired missiles at a Greek tanker. Apparently no casualties. Meantime, another U.S.-led convoy is making its way through the Persian Gulf. In other news today, Mutual Pentagon correspondent Bob Whitten reports the size of this latest U.S. convoy flies in the face of what Joint Chief of Staff Chairman Admiral William Crowe told a Senate panel yesterday. Today is expected to be the last in the confirmation hearings for Judge Robert Bork. And according to Senate Majority Whip Alan Cranston, it could mark the end of the Bork nomination. Senator Cranston says his latest head count shows 49 votes likely to be cast against Bork. Two magazines claim that dozens of prominent American authors have been kept under government surveillance because their writing was considered subversive. Among the authors named by the articles were Hemingway, Steinbeck, Capote, Mailer, Perlbach, and Sinclair Lewis. An FBI spokesman denies the surveillance is continuing. Fred Lowry, Mutual Update.
A private funeral service for Henry Ford II has been scheduled for Friday at Christ Church in Grosse Pointe Farms. A public memorial service will be held a week from tomorrow at a time and place to be announced. Mayor Coleman Young has ordered flags in Detroit to be flown at half staff until then. Ford died yesterday of complications from pneumonia. He was 70 years old. An estimated 10,000 people rallied at the Capitol in Lansing yesterday to urge passage of a bill allowing non-certified teachers to teach in religious schools. The chairman of the House Education Committee predicts the measure will fail to pass. The rally was an effort by Christian groups to press the committee to pass one form of the legislation to protect the rights of private schools. The Public Service Commission has ordered a public review to help determine how much Consumers Power Company can charge for energy generated at its proposed Midland gas-fired electric plant. The plant will be constructed as a joint venture between Consumers Power and Dow Chemical Company on the site of the defunct Midland Nuclear Power Plant. The utility has proposed charging 4.15 cents per kilowatt hour, but the Attorney General's office says that rate is much too high. Police in the Detroit area have been put on alert for a convicted murderer who walked away from a prison in Pellston, and Brian Mulvaney explains.
State police say that Ronald Hartwig apparently walked away from the Pellston prison camp between 2 and 4 o'clock yesterday afternoon. The 39-year-old former Detroit resident has a history of psychological problems, and corrections officials consider him extremely dangerous. Police currently centering their investigation on the Detroit area. This is Brian Mulvaney reporting.
Next Tuesday, voters in West Traverse Township near Harbor Springs are asked to support a quarter mill to renew the township's lease to run the Thornswift Nature Preserve. Thomas Bailey of the Little Traverse Conservancy explains why the vote is called.
5 years ago, an agreement was reached between West Traverse Township and the Little Traverse Conservancy that the township would lease and operate the Thornswift Nature Preserve. That lease expires this year, and the millage, which was levied in West Traverse Township to support it, expires this year.
The 32-acre park is used by many groups. Township trustees Britt Gordon says he's optimistic that voters will approve the new millage. Sports: Tigers crushing the Baltimore Orioles 10-1 in American League Baseball action from last night. The Detroit victory, coupled with a 5-3 Milwaukee victory over the Toronto Blue Jays, puts the Tigers a game and a half now behind the Blue Jays in the American League Eastern Division. Baltimore and Detroit go at it again tonight, continuing their series. Walt Terrell scheduled to be on the mound for the Tigers. WMBN weather for Northern Michigan in a moment.
Here's a message from your Big Eye guys, Centennial Insurance Associates in Petoskey.
If you own a home, you may have a problem with crabgrass or property tax, so auto owners think you don't need a problem with your insurance. That's why the economical homeowners policy offers guaranteed home replacement protection for qualified homes. Just ask your auto owner's agent.
For all your insurance needs, consult the Big Eye Guys, your independent insurance agent on Bay Street, Petoskey. Call 347-2525 today.
Auto owners, no problem, people.
WMBN weather for Northern Michigan for today. Partly sunny skies, breezy and cool, but we can't rule out the risk of shower activity all day long today. High temperature 58. North, northwesterly winds 10 to 20 miles an hour and gusty. Partly cloudy and cool tonight. The overnight low 37. Frost, scattered frost in the low-lying areas a possibility. Increasing cloudiness and continued cool on Thursday. Chance of afternoon showers. High temperature tomorrow, 56 degrees. Cloudy skies, a few light scattered showers reported across the north. 45 at Pellston, 48 at Sheboygan, 50 at Petoskey and Charlevoix, 47 degrees in Gaylord. Cloudy skies for the most part, few scattered showers in and around Traverse City, and 51 degrees. That's the 7 o'clock news. This is Jim Scollin reporting. And now more of today's easy listening music from 96.3 FM WMBN. playing your very favorite songs the easy way. We're 96.3 FM WMBN. 7:08 is the time. It's a Wednesday morning with Jim Scollin. Partly sunny skies in our forecast for today with a high temperature of 58. About a 40% chance of that shower activity, though, all day long. Today is Wednesday, September 30th, last day of the month, 273rd day of the year. Just 92 left to go now in 1987. Those born on this date under the sign of Libra include German physicist Hans Geiger, co-inventor of the Geiger counter in 1882, film director Louis Milestone in 1895, former Georgia Governor Lester Maddox in 1915, 72 years old today, novelist Truman Capote in 1924, actresses Deborah Kerr in 1921, 66 years old today, Angie Dickinson, the policewoman in 1931, 56 years old today, and singer Johnny Mathis in 1935, 52 years old today. On this date in history, in 1846, a dentist in Charleston, Massachusetts, extracted a tooth for the first time with the aid of anesthetic ether. In 1938, Germany, France, Britain, and Italy met in Munich for a conference after which British Prime Minister Neville Chamberlain predicted peace for our time. World War II began less than 1 year later. In 1946, the verdicts were handed down in the Nuremberg War Crimes Trial. 12 Nazi leaders were sentenced to death by hanging. And in 1955, movie idol James Dean died in a car crash at the age of 24. Our thought for the day today, author Truman Capote observed, New York is the only real city, and Venice is like eating an entire box of chocolate liqueurs at one time. And that's your history lesson for the day. Don't forget, we've got our weekly quiz coming up on Friday morning, so be ready. 10 minutes after 7, here's Neil Sedaka from 96.3 FM WMBN.
It's wrong to say, I don't think of you. God's way.
easy listening music for all of Northern Michigan from 96.3 FM.
Just in time for fall and winter, the Pendleton Shop in Gaylord is having a coat sale for men and women. The Pendleton Shop on West Main Street in downtown Gaylord has a large selection of winter coats on sale just when you need them most. For the men, there are coats by Gordon and Ferguson and London Fog, all marked down 20%. The ladies will find coats by McIntosh, London Fog, and David Brooks at great savings. Dress coats, down-fill jackets, and more are marked down right now at the Pendleton Shop in downtown Gaylord. Hurry in for the best selection.
Ooh.
Ooh, what?
What's that?
What's what?
What I'm staring at.
Oh, that's a wart.
A wart?
A worry wart.
A worry wart?
Yeah.
How interesting.
Yeah.
How'd you get it?
It was free.
Free?
Yeah, yeah, I got a worry wart with my new muffler.
Your new muffler? Didn't you mitocize?
Oh, no, no. See, I went where I could worry if they did it right the first time and worry if I paid too much and worry if the company will still be in business if I have to go back and get them to do it over again and worry about this and worry about that and worry.
And for that, you got a worry wart?
Yeah, a worry wart. It was a special promotion. See, if I got them to do my breaks, I could have gotten two worry warts.
Free.
Free.
Bring your muffler problems to Midas and stop worrying, because Midas gets it right the first time. And it's backed by the dependable, unbeatable Midas guarantee.
They sure put it in a funny place.
Now, do you think so?
I do.
Because I could have gotten it here.
Ugh.
What do you think if I would have had it here?
Oh.
Oh, you like it there.
For expert service, see your Petoskey Midas dealer at 1061 U.S. Route 31 North, across from Bayview Golf Course. Midas size. Get it right the first time.
It's 1 minute before 8 o'clock, and you're listening to WMBN-FM 96.3, Petoskey, Traverse City. The news this hour being brought to you by Pumpco Interiors and their custom sleep center featuring the famous Simmons Beauty Rest Mattress. Pumpco Interiors on the Harbor Petoskey Road, Petoskey.
Some of America's best-known authors reportedly were kept under surveillance by the FBI and other government agencies. Articles in two magazines make that claim. Among the dozens of authors reportedly involved, Ernest Hemingway, Carl Sandburg, William Faulkner, and Tennessee Williams. A few major blazes left over from a month of forest and brush fires in the Pacific Northwest continue to burn. In the past 24 hours, another firefighter lost his life battling those fires. Vice President Bush is now in West Germany for talks with leaders of that NATO nation. They are expected to tell Bush they think any future arms talks with the Soviets should include conventional arms reduction. Fred Lowry, Mutual Update.
A private funeral service for Henry Ford II has been scheduled for Friday at Christ Church in Grosse Pointe Farms. A public memorial service will be held a week from tomorrow at a time and place to be announced later. Mayor Coleman Young has ordered flags in Detroit to be flown at half-staff until then. Ford died yesterday of complications from pneumonia. He was 70 years old. The Public Service Commission has ordered a public review to help determine how much Consumers Power Company can charge for energy generated at its proposed Midland gas-fired electric plant. The plant will be constructed at a joint venture between Consumers Power and Dow Chemical Company on the site of the defunct Midland nuclear plant. The utility has proposed changing 4.15 cents per kilowatt hour, but the Attorney General's office says that rate is too high. Police in the Detroit area have been put on alert for a convicted murderer who walked away from a prison in Pelston. Brian Mulvaney explains.
State police say that Ronald Hartwig apparently walked away from the Pelston prison camp between 2 and 4 o'clock yesterday afternoon. The 39-year-old former Detroit resident has a history of psychological problems, and corrections officials consider him extremely dangerous. Police currently centering their investigation on the Detroit area. This is Brian Mulvaney reporting.
Duck hunting season opens Saturday in the Upper Peninsula and northern lower Michigan area. Hans Borger spoke with a Petoskey duck hunter to profile this report.
Dan D'Agostino says duck hunting is an art, especially with all the decoys and duck calls a hunter has to learn to use. He gives us an example of some of the calls to try and hail ducks. If the ducks are already in a group, use this. D'Agostino says duck calls take a lot of time to learn.
Well, it takes a long time to learn how to call ducks and to use these different types of calls. A lot of times when you're first starting out, what you can just simply do is get out there and just learn how to quack. And if you do that, you do it good, you can bring ducks in, especially if there's not a lot of competition out from other people around you. Just go like this.
And so all the duck hunters out there, we wish you good luck. I'm Hans Borger reporting.
And those duck hunters may have a chilly time of it this coming weekend. The National Weather Service says a frost and freeze advisory is in effect for portions of northern Michigan tonight. Very cold air spreading over the state this morning and will cover the state today and tonight before moving off to the east tomorrow. Clearing skies tonight across the eastern portions of the Upper Peninsula and extreme northern lower Michigan will allow temperatures to fall into the low to mid-30s. Frost is likely in northern sections of the state by tomorrow morning. Sports: Tigers over the Baltimore Orioles 10-1 in American League Baseball action from last night. The Detroit victory coupled with a 5-3 Milwaukee victory over Toronto puts the Tigers a game and a half now behind the Blue Jays in the American League Eastern Division. WMBN weather for northern Michigan in a moment.
Umco Interiors announces a spectacular one-time offer that ends today. The Custom Sleep Center at Bumco and Simmons have slashed prices on Simmons Beauty Rest Classic Extra Firm sets, but the offer ends today. You'll find a queen set that was originally priced at $844, now only $489, and more. But the offer ends today. Stop by or call the Custom Sleep Center at Bumco and take advantage of these Super Simmons specials.
Floor covering, custom earphone, custom drape, interior design. Together in our new gallery on the Harbor Petoskey Road, Petoskey.
WMBN weather for northern Michigan, partly sunny, breezy, and cool today. Chance of a shower. High temperature today, 58. North-northwesterly winds, 10 to 20 miles an hour and gusty. Partly cloudy and cool tonight. The overnight low of 37. Scattered frost possible in those low-lying areas. Increasing cloudiness for Thursday and continued cool. High temperature tomorrow, 56 degrees. Partly cloudy conditions across the north at this hour. 48 at Pelston, 49 at Sheboygan, 51 at Petoskey and Charlevoix, 48 degrees at Gaylord. Partly cloudy conditions in and around Traverse City, and 52 degrees. That's the 8 o'clock news. This is Jim Scollin reporting. And now more of today's easy listening music from 96.3 FM WMBN.